I have. Let's see if you know the answer to this. What country gave us the Statue of Liberty? What? Yeah, shout it out. Correct. Okay. What country was the first one to use paper money? China. Correct. China it was. Okay, and I have one more question. What fruit is the most favorite and consumed around the world? What fruit do you think it is? Correct, Mike. Bananas. Do you know how many bananas that people eat in the whole world in 1 year? Take a guess. Five bananas, no. 40 tons. 40 tons of bananas. That's all. That's all. 40 tons. Okay, so it's Question Sunday because our scripture is about Thomas and the other disciples. And Thomas had some questions. Thomas was curious because it was a very scary time because it was just a couple days after Jesus had died and Jesus had rose again and they weren't sure if that really happened and they were afraid for what people would think if they were with Jesus. There was a lot going on. So there was a lot of questioning happening. So Thomas, since he wasn't there, only heard that Jesus had appeared. So he had more questions. He was more curious. Now, imagine if you were in a classroom with your teacher, whatever your teacher is, and no one ever asked any questions. Everyone just sat there, heard what the teacher said. Even if you didn't understand, you never asked any questions, what would happen? What would happen to yourself? You might get a bad grade because you wouldn't understand, would you? Because you wouldn't learn anything. I know pretty much every teacher has special hours after school that you can come and get special help. And if no one ever came to get special help, no one would ever learn anything. So are questions a good thing or a bad thing, I think?
Good
thing, that's right, Mike. Questions are a good thing. So that's where Thomas gets a bad rap, like Mary was saying. Questions are a good thing. Now, what about questions with our faith? Questions with us believing in Jesus, good or bad? Good. Because you know what? On our journey in faith, I have questions every day. Why wasn't I taller? How come not prettier? How come I couldn't be a Broadway star? Things like that. God, why did that not happen? Why is somebody that I really, really care about sick? Why is there illness in our world? If God is so wonderful, why is there things like that? There's questions that we each have every day. And sometimes we get some questions answered, but then the next day we have a few more questions. And you know what? We're going to keep questioning till the end of time. A friend of ours, Phyllis, who just passed away, she was a great questioner. She had questions for people she met. She had questions for other teachers she met. She had questions about her faith. She was always questioning up until the last day. And that makes us a wonderful child of God because we're questioners. And I'm going to tell you a little story. When I was in seventh grade, and at the church I was growing up in, we had a class that we went to for a whole year where we were able to become members of the church. And being the kind of person that I was, you'll just be shocked that I had a lot of questions. I thought maybe things should be this way. And why did we do them this way and not that way? Well, it scared our minister. They had to have a special meeting and decide what I could do in the church. Well, that wouldn't happen here at Pilgrim, would it? We can have all the questions we want. And if you're not questioning, then I'm a little worried because you're not learning anything new. So questions are important. Questions are wonderful, and Jesus showed up because Thomas had those questions and he needed them answered. So Jesus was there. So questions are good. So always, always keep questioning. Today we're going to close instead of a words of prayer, we're going to sing a little song. It's to Frere Jacques, so you all know that too. The words are, peace be with you, peace be with you, trust in me, I will always love you. I will always love you. because that's the one question that always the answer is yes to. Jesus loves me. Peace be with you.